My name is Hertling, and I am a soldier. Right now, there are dignitaries, ambassadors, statesmen, politicians, and generals traveling to various battlefields throughout the United States and throughout Europe, and all are speaking about those who sacrificed. But for Sue, my wife, and me, the field here at Margraten will forever symbolize how to best memorialize soldiers. Because we will always remember our visit here last Christmas Eve. You see, we had been invited to attend the Christmas Eve Mass at the Deschart Cave Complex, a place very close to here. Many of you know of it and have been touched by its story. But for those who don't know the story of the cave, during the bloody winter of 1944, when bitter cold denied respite from the gruesome fighting, and when bombs fell like an incessant rain on friends and foe alike, young men, Dutch civilians, and American soldiers gathered in the Deschart Cave to celebrate Christmas Eve. Carved out of sandstone by the brothers of the Bayard Monastery centuries ago, the Deschart Cave became the place where those recently liberated, those from the Netherlands, and those who had liberated them, the American soldiers, came together to celebrate Christmas Mass. An emotion as conflicted as Christmas in wartime itself was in the air of the cave. Having spent three Christmases in combat, I know the feeling. The hope and new and everlasting life balanced with the fear associated with imminent danger. On one side of the cave were the liberated Dutch people, tasting freedom for the first time in 4 years. But the Americans, who were on the other side of the cave, who were resting after months of hard fighting, starting at Normandy, had just received orders telling them they would reinforce their brothers near a place called Bastogne. Those young men tempered the celebration of that Christmas Eve night with a sobriety known only to those who know that they will soon face danger. 67 years have passed since that Christmas Eve service. 67 years since 300 Americans who shared communion with their Dutch brothers signed their name on the wall of the cave in charcoal and left to fight in a town not too far from here. Very few of them would see another Christmas. In the 67 years since, the seeds of hope and joy planted by those young men and watered with their blood have been recalled by the Dutch people in that cave on Christmas Eve, year after year. Sue and I learned of that story last Christmas Eve when we took communion at the Deschart Cave. But before we went to Mass, we came here to the cemetery. On a cold, rainy Christmas Eve afternoon, before we went to Mass, when most Europeans are gathering with family, preparing for the Christmas celebrations, we came here, and we did not expect to see what we saw. Arriving just back there in the parking lot, we observed a steady stream of Dutch families, all with flowers and cards, all visiting this cemetery, visiting the graves of Americans cemetery, we saw an elderly man carefully tending a grave right over there. We stood here and watched him as he spent several minutes in silent reflection, pausing to wipe a drop of rainwater off the tombstone of the soldier he had adopted. As he got up to leave, Sue and I approached with a little bit of courage and gently asked him if the grave was of someone he knew and what that soldier's story might have been. That's when we learned of the incredible loyalty of the people. additional 1,722 are memorialized along the Court of Honor back by the reflection pool. Although the American Battle Monuments Commission preserves this sacred place with diligent reverence, and thank you for that, the people of Margraten enliven each of these graves through the blessings of gratitude and a living memorial. It amazed us to find that since this place was established in December 1944, the people of Margraten have taken it upon themselves to adopt these sites to honor these graves. And their only connection is to the soldiers buried there is an eternal gratitude for their individual freedom. You know, when my staff heard I was coming here, one of my colonels wrote me a note about a family member buried here. His uncle, he told me, lies at Margraten. Anton C. Simon, known as Beaner to his family. He was a radio operator killed by a sniper just one heartbreaking month before the war ended. This colonel then told me that a Dutch family named Reinbout, I'm hoping they're here in the crowd, adopted his uncle, looking after his grave, and even hosting his grandmother on the three visits that she paid here to Margraten. He asked me if I could give the Reinbout thanks and the people of this town his sincere gratitude. I'm sure that the Reinbouts are just like that elderly man that Sue and I observed over there just last Christmas. But I would like to pass the thanks to the Reinbout family and the thanks of all Americans to the people of Margraten who tend to our soldiers here. Yours are acts of respect and loyalty learned from fathers and mothers, passed to sons and daughters. We are honored to be here with those who gave their lives, those out there. But we are also very honored to be with the people of Margraten, who will never forget that young American men died here so that those they didn't even know would know freedom. 67 years have brought healing and hope. Wife.